How's it going, YouTube? I am Pib, or Mr. Pib, back at it again with another reaction video. Going to be listening to Logic's Young Sinatra 4. So, if in case you don't know what YSIV means, it is Young Sinatra 4. So, really happy to hear this and see what Logic has in store for me. Haven't heard any of these yet. Has some really good features, though. Hailee Steinfeld, we have Big Lambo, of course. Jaden Smith, Iconic. That I'm looking forward to that song as well. But let's just go right into it. Like and subscribe if you do enjoy it. I really appreciate it, guys. Let's get into it.
I mean, the final Young Sinatra. The fourth one.
Oh, shit, man. You had me tripping.
The final one, huh? Yeah, final one.
Let's get back to this boom bap shit.
Young Sinatra to Tarantino. We know he do that. Bitch, I got that flame. Who that? I'm the new Kanye. When they was like, who?
I'm the new Kanye. Ooh, Logic out here saying, I'm the new Kanye. I love Kanye West, so... I do really enjoy Logic's music as well. Obviously, that is Logic's last album. Really big fan of Logic as well. Interesting comparison, though. Let's listen more. Sinatra. So that's super cool. The rest of the song, just a lot of people, you know, just shouting out, saying what's up. Really, really cool, though, from Logic. Really cool introduction. That was Thank You, featuring Lucy Rose in the Rat Pack. Going into song number two now, Everybody Dies. I've heard this before. I jammed to this shit. Good song. Let's get it. Wait, is this a different Everybody Dies? Oh, no, I haven't heard this song.
Fuck that shit.
You want 10 years and running, we came up in the basement. Grew up broke as fuck, rich folks was adjacent. Maryland staring out the window for motivation. I mean, I am not top 10, more like top 3. I am not 2, cuz nobody could top me. Got more verses than the Holy Bible, motherfucker, cuz
hey.
I'm sitting on 5. But bitch, I am me, they hate what I represent.
But they stay in me.
It's nothing but legendary shit that be going on, the phenomenon.
You're watching a master.
The walk like Michael on the moon. Rap pack, bleed up its tone. So much more is coming soon. Yeah, I've been going, I'm already knowing. Nobody been going. My shit get around like a woman that's on. My body been going, my mind been going. I'm already knowing that I'm gonna die one day. You
really good song, though. Just really cool beat. And, decent. Yeah, it was a good song, of course. And now we're going into The Return.
Satisfied.
Yeah.
I love this vibe that he sets with Young Sinatra. Like, kind of has the instrumentals, like the orchestra kind of instruments going through most of these songs, it seems.
Last time I said it went viral, I don't fuck with nobody.
Hey.
And I don't fuck with you, them, her, and him too. Cause don't none of y'all know a fucking thing about what I'm. It ain't no S on my chest, but I'm still gunning. While half of these motherfuckers still running. I burn everything I've attained and they steal from them. Like I used to call you a hater, you a motherfucking stan. Ain't nobody built himself a brand like me.
I just want to point out, he says stan a lot in a couple first songs already. Like, fans that hate you. I don't really know. Like, I know it's from Eminem's song, Stan, but I guess it's literally about an over-obsessive fans, you know? I guess I would say. It's interesting, though, that that's become such a thing.
Got $6 and six figures on the creep. Cause in the end, we all 6 feet deep.
True.
Meanwhile, I caught a faggot, a nigger, a cracker. Who wish you was blacker? I wish I could face my homophobic racist attacker and smack a shit.
Oh, that's crazy. That's I mean, I feel like that's the kind of hate that Logic gets, though. That's the thing. You know, people making fun of him for, you know, being half black, half white. You know, you want to trying to be so white, you're trying to be so black. It's like Logic's just trying to do Logic, man. I don't understand why people gotta hate on him so much. It just doesn't make sense to me.
Way too many people feel how I feel. That's on the real, on the motherfucking real. I get up when I'm down, had enough. Fuck a Trump, said that shit on my last album, but you wasn't tapping in. Fuck a mumble, let's make America rap again.
Hey.
Industry don't give a fuck about rapper, what's happening. Fuck a rap beef, I promise I want all of y'all to prosper. But
hey, that's a cool line, though. Fuck a rap beef, I promise I want all of y'all to aspire. Or I want all of y'all to prosper. That's really dope. And then he goes on to say, but deep down you know it's only gonna be one Mufasa. That's dope, though. He's like, I want everyone to do well, but I'm the king here. So that's super cool. I think that's a cool line.
I love all you motherfuckers, just wanna hear you spit. Drop my last shit, the whole wide world applauded it. Game still ain't
I don't know if the whole wide world applauded it. You know, I liked it. Obviously it's right there. There. I liked it. Obviously, it was a good album. Well, I don't think everybody thought it was a really good album, but it was still a good album.
Game still ain't give me my credit, so I'm a audit it. I'm heartless like Kanye and 08. Yeah, that's...
My man just made a Kanye reference. Heartless like Kanye and 08. One of the best Kanye West songs out there. You can't say I'm wrong. Heartless slapped. 808s and Heartbreaks. also slapped. He's referencing Kanye West a lot, which is obviously, you know, big inspiration going on. So that's dope from him. No Kanye's in collaboration on the album though. So, you know, we'll see if that ever works out.
I'm calling out Jay-Z to jump up on the track with me and smack the whole industry. Show him what that
I'm calling out Jay-Z to jump on the track with me and smack the whole industry. Oh, I'm trying to see a Jay-Z and Logic collaboration real quick.
Not when to talk about popping pills and sipping lean, just a passing for pussy. I'm trying to get up in a spleen. This is my mentality, rapping at 19. But that man priority was hug up with a fatty. But I'm glad he did, cause it made me who I am. Now I'm the man that I always wish he would have been and never started smoking crack.
Hey, this is a super dope song though. So yeah, obviously it seems like Logic's grown up without a father here. But it seems like Glorious 5 is purely just on him. I would say shit talking his father in this situation and just kind of being like, I'm the better version of him. I'm glad I ain't doing all that shit. So I mean, hey, good for Logic, you know, to get out of a family like, or to get out of a situation like that, not to grow up to be like his dad.
I feel like my late mission is to be the best dad when the time comes for my daughter and my son. When the time comes, teach them about their heritage and where they come from. Teach them about their family history and then some.
Hey, that's dope. I feel like a lot of people that grow up without fathers, I'm you know, blessed to still a family with two parents, but I feel like a lot of people that grow up without fathers, it's like their goal to, you know, to try and be better than their dad, or to try and, you know, be the best dad they can. And I fucking respect the shit out of that. I feel like if like that really encourages you to do better and to really take care of your kids, man, I think that's awesome. And obviously it's shitty not to grow up without two parents or to have a dad or a mom, you know, it's shitty, of course, but it's dope that Logic kind of relates that back, and he's like, even though I had a shitty father, I'm gonna be the best one ever. It's like, it's a super cool mindset to have, and I respect that. Let's listen to the rest of the song. That was a super dope song, Glorious 5. Going on to One Day, featuring Ryan Tedder. Never heard of Ryan Tedder, so interesting. Gonna be hearing him for the first time.
And maybe one day I'll be wise.
Oh, I've heard this before, I think.
Alright. You ever wonder what it means to make it by any means?
I've heard this song.
Your 10 dreams on a come up, but they run up from the world of many fiends. I've been at it since a teen, and it don't matter where you at. If you white or if you black, if you rich or you poor, we gonna always want more. But one thing I can be sure, cause maybe one day I'll be falling from here.
This is a super dope chorus. I actually really enjoy Ryan Tedder's voice.
Drugs in a household, never had a hand to hold. Even when I was homeless in a blistering cold.
Like that vibe, it's a really chill song. This next song, though, I'm extremely excited for, called Wu-Tang Forever, featuring Ghostface Killa, Raekwon, RZA, Method Man, Inspecta Deck, Capadonna, Jackpot, Scotty, Waddy, You God, Master Killa, and GZA. So, this is gonna be lit.
Hey,
yo. Wu-Tang style, I leave them all dismembered. Fuck a mumble rap, that shit won't never be remembered. Not even
facts. Mumble rap will never be forevered. I always thought, like, growing up, you know, what is our generation's kind of music? You know, it's like, in my head, I think EDM, pretty popular now. Probably stuff like that. And I'm like, fucking mumble rap became a huge thing in our generation. He's right, though. Mumble rap is not gonna last forever.
Assassinating every single motherfucking borough, from Staten to Brooklyn to Queens, the Bronx and Harlem, all the way to Maryland. Yeah, we coming for all. Who you know assembled a clan like Voltron, the one and only Logic. The guess who stepped in the role? It's Ghostface, Gold Place, O2, Smoke K, Intelligent Brothers with nine hoods, moving snowflakes, guillotine your head last seen in the showcase.
Oh, Ghostface Killa killed that shit, dude. That was a nice flow. I feel now in. I think Raekwon's next.
I'm the haze in the crib with my blades. It gets messy underneath the dress of the gauge. A specialist when I'm baking. Rhymes be coming out, we making. The challenge any chumps but lumps. Here's the statement. Stop hating. The crew is all about getting this cake. And you know about me, you relate.
Beer mixers of hipsters, weed smokers and beer drinkers. Prince and the pauper, spiritual clear thinkers. Cake in the oven, super bad like McLovin hugging on.
Dude, this beat is fire though. I could just bob my head to this shit. But this is pretty dope so far, for sure.
Rap vocabulary's weakening. I felt it coming like the weekend when these star boys start tweaking. Sporadic feel prepare when you need one. I got a light beam gun. I blast a hole in your chest that you can't bleed from. But you die your iniquity for stupidity of that trickery. You can never get rid of me. Step back and consider me. Rule killer bee, but I'm not big on bigotry.
Hey.
Old school on this track. I'm feeling invincible. The more clowns than the Motown. Get put in critical. The gun smoky. Robinson, you need a miracle. Go back home. Back when rappers ship of one nation under God, that's indivisible. My time critical, hands off from digital.
Hot shit, I drop quick. Major player, watch my stock lift. Razor blade sharpness, regardless of whom or what. Zero game, Wu-Tang pumping through your veins. 25 years, still more of the same.
Hey.
The flow like water with the boiling flame.
Hey.
Survival of the fittest in cold days with no money. They don't want me with stacks, they better take it from me. You know the currency gone as soon as you break a 20. Then we create wars, everybody is a gangbanger. We kill each other, but we all got the same anger.
We killing each other, but we all got the same anger. That like sent chills down my spine, dog.
I know your mama told you that I was a great dude. These dirty ass cops to kill and rape you. Want some Jason shit, might crystal in the lake you.
Hey, Jason reference.
What? They might crystal in the lake you.
Boom, you get killed for joking. Everybody's hoping. That's another level of emotion. Food stamps, niggas doing grocery. Police wanna grope me. I'm giving bitches something to breathe on. I rip off a shoulder to lean on.
Oh.
It's fair game, it's two in the lane.
Loosen up my arms. Can I get comfortable? Stay on my tiptoes. Old school woo beat. This is a flip phone. Dude, just slip showing. Stars and bars makes me a general. Anything less makes me a criminal.
I'm just saying.
G-O-D. Shadow box with the L-O-G-I-C. On a Wu-Tang, first master you're breathing. Arms to hold my microphone, you need iron palms. Remain calm, Jamel, I be wise chief. Wu-Tang, poison clansman from the east.
Food for thought, impossible sliders with the seasoning. Regardless, I speak logic, clear reasoning. The uncivilized, get the mineralized quartz. Self-directed, calculated, controlled thought.
The faculty, ain't nothing going on, don't nothing move. Nobody slide, nobody get hurt.
Wu-Tang saw, can he beat me?
Oh, that was a dope song. Getting all the Wu-Tang people on that shit. That was dope. Next, we got 100 Miles and Running featuring Wale and John Lindahl.
Niggas not allowed.
I put it on everything I really want to cop out. But I did good for a drop out. Woo!
In the song now. Everybody know that it's on now.
Oh, damn.
Nevada shout out.
I'm ripping and living and striving to kill her. The ripper, he calling with going and flowing. You know he was doing it, doing it, moving and grooving and stopping it. I gotta talk it, walk it, flip it, ripping. I'm under the fucking script. No.
Oh my God, Logic's out here.
Don't do this shit in one breath, alright? This ain't no bullshit. This ain't This ain't no editing. We gon' do it like this. Y'all ready?
Boys and ladies, if you're watching, I'm ready.
Yeah. I'm living, living, striving, killing the ribby, calling it, going it, flowing, he was assuming it, doing it, moving it, grooving it, stopping it, breaking it, talking it, working it, flipping it, ripping it, I'm under the fucking script, and I'm ready to go when I buy it, then break it, roll it, then lick it, and smoke it, choke it, hell yeah. Say hell yeah.
That shit slapped. Logic Flow on that was crazy. That last breath was crazy. Next song is going to be Ordinary Day featuring Haley Steinfeld. Let's get it.
This the type of shit I like. Everyone just living life. Living life like this is dangerous. And it really ain't just the famous. Everybody from the young to the old. Anybody with a little bit of money gets shameless. How about I look in your eyes? I can tell by the fact you don't know how to act. I see right through your lies.
Hey.
I'm a real motherfucker, but you know about that. Like, yeah, what's up? Everybody out here acting tough. I'm Mikey, I know you. But bitch, I've been here before you. I'ma show you. I'ma show you, I'ma show you. And so they tell me that they love me, but I know that it's all for show. Lovely, but she know that it's all for show.
Where does Haley
Steinfeld go with song? So then the night goes on and on and on.
I feel like that song had a happy vibe to me. Like the song Happy by Pharrell Williams. Kind of just like one of those, you're just walking the street and you're just like, oh, no, no, you just kind of do the Carlton dance. Now we got YSIV, aka Young Sinatra 4, the actual song title, so let's get it. I love saxophones, man.
Rest in peace, Mac Miller.
Well, we caught that. Rest in peace, Mac Miller, of course. One of the greats, in my opinion. Love saxophones, though. Like, I'm really excited to hear the rest of the song because I love saxophones.
Like 10 years. Here we go.
Popping like Jay-Z, dirty dancing on the game like Swayze. I'm one of the innocent, bitch, I've been ready to kill us, it's so amazing. Bitch, I've been blazing, I'm talking grass, I ain't talking grazing. They just sit the tape while I sip scotch. Let it get us how you know I made it. I'm one of the illest, I'm one of the realest, I'm one of the killers, the people, they feel us. Me and my team made millions, but you know we still us.
Wait, where are they?
Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go.
So they sampled Life's a Bitch. Interesting. I like it.
They want the old logic, the one that flow like a frost. I'm still the same me. They just don't believe it like they agnostic. And my production selection is still flame. But they love you on the come up because you ain't tainted by fame. And you're still their little secret.
True. Hey, that's how a lot of people feel with Logic right now. A lot of OG fans don't fuck with Logic anymore because he's famous now. Which I don't get. Obviously, he made really good music back then. And he's still making good music back now. Why aren't you still a fan of him? If you're an OG fan, you'd still support him. Now, you'd support him even more now because he got famous. Like, you don't just like, you know, oh, I'm the only one that can like Logic because I liked him first. It's like, no, dog. Just be happy he's successful. Making good shit.
From Nasty Nas, Big L Tribe, The Roots, and many more. Of course, we can never forget Biggie and Young Shakur. Fuck the police. No, we ain't fucking with El Pastor. I've got the bread, but these fuckers need the dough like a baker. The legends above me love me like the RZA, like Nas, like Jay. Cause hey. I mastered the flow from back in the day. Respected by my peers from Drizzy to Cole to Kenny. Thank you for love and inspiration plenty.
Hey, so shouting out, I said Drizzy, Cole, and Kenny. So Drake, J. Cole, and Kendrick Lamar, I'm assuming. And then he also shouted out RZA, Nas, and Jay. I'm assuming Jay-Z. So, dope, little shout out there.
I think it's time to switch the lyricism, peep the riddle. I was born in a condition, I'm everybody's life mission. I'm right, listen, put me round your neck and I might glisten.
We love and miss you, Mac. For those of y'all who don't know, man, Mac is the whole reason that I started doing this Young Sinatra shit.
Hey, dope Mac Miller shout out.
And if it wasn't for him killing that beat, I would have never got on that beat. My very first mixtape, Young Broken Infamous. And I titled the track Young Sinatra. And that was the birth of all this shit. Yeah, we just some motherfucking kids.
Hey, I like the reference to the kids album, Mac Miller's mixtape. That sucks though, man. I'm so sad that Mac Miller is dead, bro. That 26, that's so young, dude. Next song is Street Dreams 2.
I tried to shake it, man. I can't believe this shit is real. Heart pumping on the 101. This shit right here ain't no fun. Live and die by the gun. Get you some. Pull out a 50 and told him to hurry. He moving slowly. He ain't got a worry in the world and an attitude. Maybe I was acting rude. Hold up, if the person you love was kidnapped, what would you do? Trying to get some gas. Now his brain's blast. Frozen thinking about what just happened. Now it's in the past. Jumping the whip 0 to 60. Yeah, we out fast. Swerve left, swerve right. Now they on my side of sight. Finna pull under the bridge, they won't spot me here at night. Slow it down, play it cool. Mama shit, raise no fools. Flip.
Oh.
Freeze, you motherfucker!
Six, come on, get up.
I'm shot!
What?
What's the picture they gon' paint after he go? Last song he ever sung, when a bullet hit his lung. All he tried to do was help save my wife. Wish I could've saved his life. I wish I could take it back. Now my best friend's like curtain call, fade to black. It just ain't no turning back. Look at the Addy in the text with my girl whereabouts. 5 minutes later, now I'm creeping in the warehouse. Lights on, now I see my wife, she tied up to a chair. With a gun to her head and a man gripping her hair. All I did was stop and stare. He took the gag out of her mouth and she started calling my name. So I shot him quick in the neck and he hit the floor. Before I untied her, I shot him 4 more times. Staring at the man, gun in his hand, it couldn't be. The man who kidnapped my wife was me.
Whoa. Hey, wait, what? I mean, I know this is all, you know, a metaphor for whatever, but I'm wondering if he's, like, throwing it back to his whole, obviously his ex-wife now, Jessica Andrea, who's beautiful, by the way. Interesting song though, for sure. Interesting way to end that too. It was real dope. Now we got The Adventures of Stony Bob featuring Keijo, Slaydro. I don't know if I'm saying these right, in Big Limbo. I'm gonna pause that before I start. It's 4 minutes and 20 seconds. That's Stony Bob. Think we get the vibe here.
I'm about to run a train on this girl with all my boys, and her name is Mary Jane. Cause hey. I'm with my dogs. Joe Clay wrote a blunt so big that shit looked like a log. Now I got my green belt, and that's the longest line without a rhyme. But the punch before the line about the line was so divine. For shizzle my nizzle, I feel like the double jizzle on this grizzle. Oh. My nizzle. Put the woo ha! What's the craps on the motherfucking fuck that line up?
Nice.
You make me feel so amazing.
For those who don't know, I go by Slaydro. Ready, set, go. I take one to the dome like Pablo Esco. Germinate the seed, then just let it grow.
Rap nigga shit, we Hugh Hefner. Smoke out the grotto, feeling like Pablo. Saucing like tomato, put her numbers like Lado.
Next is Legacy.
And on my deathbed, what will I say as I pray and reminisce of another day? I came from nothing, a child born in poverty. Went to college to gain knowledge so they would acknowledge me. But spent more time at work so we could have a stable life. And when my son was born, I had to work even harder. Before I knew it, now my wife is giving birth to my daughter. Weak to 80, ain't nobody gonna pay me but myself. Sacrifice my time and my health for wealth. I miss a birthday, miss an anniversary. There's lots of people in this world that worse than me.
That line right there, man, I missed a birthday, missed an anniversary. It's hard. I mean, both parents, fathers and mothers, got to put a lot of time into their children. And, you know, you see, he said his hours doubled from 40 to 80 a week. So it's like, it's huge. It's a huge difference. And I know this, you know, this is all made up, but it's super dope.
I wasn't there for my son's first words, but he ain't grow up in the hood like me. We in the burbs. Sacrifice a couple years, he can have all the money when I'm gone.
I respect that too, though. It's like he wasn't there for son's first words, obviously, because he's working so hard. But what he's saying, he's like, they're not in the hood, they're in the suburbs. That's what the burbs mean. So he's in the suburbs, and you know his son's gonna have a better life, even though you know he didn't get to hear his first words. Obviously, missed out on some huge milestones. Birthdays, anniversaries, you know, shit like that. But it's like he's working this hard to make his kids' futures better, you know? I'm just saying, generally, this is what fathers and mothers go through, man. They risk their health and their time, and they miss shit because they're really just trying to get money for their children and to see their children prosper. That's why I respect the fuck out of my parents. And
what a fool I was. I missed his graduation. I missed her wedding day. I didn't even get to give my little girl away, but I paid for the honeymoon, yeah. I had been the richest man in the world all along. A beautiful family that all I did was ignore. For financial stability and fear of being poor.
That line fits volumes too, though. Even though, you know, earlier I'm like, obviously you're gonna miss a birthday, miss an anniversary, you know, trying to get that money. But it's like, also, you know, you don't have to do that. If you're good, he's just, you know, he's saying just for the fear of being poor. You know, if you're growing up poor like he did, not having a dad, and he's like, if you're growing up poor, but he's like the richest man in the world because he's got a beautiful family. That's a super cool message too. He's like, there's two different ways to look at it, you know. You work 80 hours a week, you miss everything, but you can pay for everything. Or, you know, you work 40 hours a week, but you're there for, you know, birthdays and anniversaries, and you can be there and see the beautiful moments in life. So it's a really cool message that Logic kind of hits both sides on. It's really cool to see that.
Looking at my family like, damn, y'all were the ones. I sacrificed my life for hundreds, 50s, 20s, 10s, 5s, and 1s. So dumb, I give it all. Legacy is gone now. Sacrificed my health for wealth. No, it wasn't worth it. But as I take my last breath, I know that I deserve it. Float in the abyss of nothingness. My consciousness remembers a life before it's black. I wish that I could get back, and then I realized that all this shit is just a daydream. There's only like four of us and a tour of us, and how we as human beings sacrifice health for money. Ain't it funny? Cause in the end, we spent all our money on repairing our body and mind when we really should have just spent time.
Fucking facts. Spend all of our money repairing our body and mind when we really should have just spent time. He's like, oh dude, Logic, that was a beautiful song. Like that he hit so many good parts and good messages in that song. Now we got Iconic featuring Jaden Smith. I'm excited for this.
Shout out that boy Slim Shady for all the love.
Hey, shout out to Eminem. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Ooh. Tell me what you know about real life. Tell me what you know about Dark Knights.
Ooh.
Bitch, I'm Bruce Wayne in the game. You just perpetrating from the side.
Hey, he made a Batman reference.
Goddamn, but you know I'm putting in the work. I'ma get them, I got them, and now they all hurt. I'ma let them know, I never let them know. They never seem to know that I am a master
at work.
Everybody know that Bobby, your body, anybody like Adi, the Gambino from Maryland to Reno. We know Tarantino will kill it, but the young Sinatra got you by the neck and the spirit. The second they hear it, they fear it. As soon as they get near it, everybody revere it like on socials. Make the boy wanna go postal. Since I went triple plat, I only identify as bi-coastal.
Hey.
I don't live life like most of the life. Tell me what
chorus?
You know about Dark Knight. Dark-
this chorus fucking slaps, dude. Oh my god.
You know what that is?
Oh, where's Jaden Smith, that's baby?
Sinatra. Icons, aspire icons, gold chains wrapped around my neck like pythons.
Oh.
The drip way.
Greatest alive. I'm the greatest alive. I'm the
Wait, was that it from Jaden Smith? It just had like four lines. Fuck, I was really. This beat was hyphy. I was hoping Jaden Smith was like, cool. Drop some shit on this. Featuring Jaden Smith, Jaden Smith was barely on that song. Still a good song though. Let me come back. This shit got me hyped, but still a good song though. We on the last song of the album, Last Call. 11-minute song. Let's get it.
Got me hella excited because I always wanted to do like a Last Call. I remember the first time I heard Kanye's. I thought that shit was so tight, dog. And I was like, man, I'm trying to tell my story. You know what I'm saying?
So interesting that he mentions Last Call by Kanye. That was on College Dropout, if I remember correctly. And I think they're both super long songs. This one's almost 11 minutes. I can't remember how long the one on Kanye West album was, but I know it was long.
Infamous, the young Sinatra that was undeniable.
Hey, wait.
Who welcomed you to forever while under pressure and told you the incredible true story of Bobby Tarantino and everybody in the Ultra 85.
He just named every album he's ever made. Young Broken Infamous was his first mixtape. Like we heard earlier on, I can't remember what song it was, but then he goes to his name, Young Sinatra, he names Under Pressure. Under Pressure is when I found out about Logic. It was the song Under Pressure on his album Under Pressure. That's really when I started, you know, like fucking with Logic. I think it was on like some Call of Duty soundtrack. If I remember correctly, that's where I heard it. And I was like, fuck, dude, I fuck with Logic heavy.
And that's the same reason kids join gangs every day, because they want to be accepted, but at home they too neglected. Meanwhile, white America quick to call them a thug, but all
that's real shit, too. Logic's really good at covering a lot of this shit. It's interesting to see that take.
Never wanted was a father to give him some love. Tell him that he love him, that he need him. Promise he won't never leave him. Never smoke crack, never lie, and won't never beat him. So I'm getting ahead of myself, I'm getting ahead of myself. So like, I was staying with him and I was supposed to get a job, right? And he was like, yo, you gotta get a fucking job, bro. This shit is crazy. That's the first time I met Cole. Yo, shout out Cole, that's my fucking boy. Big Sean, all these homies, man, that I met. It was crazy. It's gonna be the last one for sure. I'm coming back with some fun, but I don't know. I love you guys. Ultra 85 is gonna be crazy.
Super dope ending. Last Call is pretty much just a 10-minute song of him talking about his life and how he got here. Super cool, super real. I feel like it was a really good album, so I'm not gonna, you know, shit talking or anything. I don't think there's any bad songs necessarily. Everything just kind of everything flowed pretty well, and Logic killed that shit. So I probably give it like an 8 out of 10. I really think that this was a good album from Logic. Also, he was talking about Ultra 85, so that's gonna be his last project. It seems he talked about his last project being Young Sinatra 4 here, which is crazy that Logic's, you know, already done with it. He's 28, I think he said he's 28 in the song, so it's crazy that he's already done. But that's it. That's the end of Young Sinatra 4. I appreciate you guys watching. Thank you for coming out watching the video. Appreciate it. Like and subscribe if you did enjoy. Join the Giraffe Gang. And I'll talk to you guys next time I make a video. Deuces.